Hello friends, Team HJ is back again with yet another video. 10 Russian weapons that will make India invincible in next war. Number 10. Infantry support weapons. The Indian Army operates around 100 units of the ZSU-23-4 Shilka self-propelled radar-guided anti-aircraft infantry support weapon. The 23mm 4-barreled system is an extremely effective weapon against enemy attack aircraft and helicopters under every weather and light condition. It has a very high density rate and accuracy of fire, as well as the capability for each of the 4 autocannons to fire its own type of projectile from separate wells. With its high rate of accurate fire, the system can neutralize tanks by destroying their gun sights, radio antennas, or other vulnerable parts. The other battlefield support system is the Tunguska, which was designed to perform roles the Shilka couldn't. Unlike the gun-only Shilka, the Tunguska is a combined gun and missile system designed to provide day and night protection for infantry and tank regiments against low-flying aircraft, helicopters, and cruise missiles in all weather conditions. Plus, its 30mm shells have greater penetrative power. India ordered 24 units of the Tunguska in 2005 and may have up to 184 in its armory today. Number 9. Multi-barrel rocket launchers, MBRLs. India has more than 150 BM-21 Grad and 62 Smerch systems. Inspired by the Russian MBRL, India now produces the Pinaka system with a reported high rate of production of 5,000 rockets per year. MBRLs have low precision compared with artillery, but they rely on a large number of shells dissipating over an area for a certain hit rate on specific targets. Plus, because of the short warning time for the impact of the whole volley, the BM-21 is considered an effective weapon. Number 8. Club missiles. This partly supersonic missile is the export version of the 2500 km caliber, which the Russian Navy has used with devastating effect against Islamic State as well as US-backed terror groups in Syria. The Club version's range is limited by the missile technology control regime to below 300 km. It is more than enough to strike at coastal targets from well within international waters. Initially, the missile flies at an altitude of 30 to 45 feet above the sea surface. Approximately 60 km away from the designated target, the club descends to 15 feet and accelerates to supersonic speed before smashing into the target. The club is also capable of performing very high angle defensive and speedy maneuvers. This is unlike the linear and predictable flight path of other anti-ship cruise missiles. Number 7. IL-78 Aerial Refueling Tankers. The Ilyushin IL-78 is the aerial refueling tanker version of the large IL-76 transport aircraft. The aircraft has two removable 18,230-liter fuel tanks installed in the flight hold, allowing up to 3 aircraft to refuel in flight simultaneously. This will enable pilots to conduct a variety of missions and surprise the enemy. Number 6. Stealth Frigates. The Talwars have a displacement of just 4,000 tons, but with a speed of 32 knots, they are among the fastest vessels in the ocean. They are capable of accomplishing a wide scale of missions in the ocean, primarily finding and eliminating submarines and large surface ships. Some talwars carry 14 vertically launched club missiles, while the newer vessels are equipped with the much larger and supersonic BrahMos anti-ship missiles. Number 5. T-90 Tanks. The T-90 is suited to lightning war for its many qualities. First up, like Rhino Skin, the tank is equipped with 3rd generation active armor capable of withstanding an attack by tank rounds designed for the latest US and European tanks. T-90 survived a direct hit by an American-made TOW anti-tank missile in Syria earlier in 2017. Unlike the hand-loaded Abrams, the T-90 uses an auto-loading system for its main gun. Russian tankers have been heard saying the Abrams is a bolt action, while the Russian T-90 is a semi-automatic. Also, it has a superior fire control system that allows it to fire with accuracy while on the move. The Indian Army has 1500 of these lean and mean killers, and more are being locally produced under license. Number 4. BrahMos Missiles. Russian and Indian engineers jointly work in this successful project, which is owned by India and Russia in the ratio of 50.5:49.5. The BrahMos is a first strike weapon that could obliterate enemy's defenses as well as its offensive capabilities quickly, surgically and effectively. Number 3. INS Chakra. INS Chakra is armed with 36 torpedoes and club anti-ship missiles. Although the nuclear submarine is intended to be a platform for familiarizing Indian sailors with the operations and tactics of a nuclear-powered and more importantly nuclear-armed submarine, INS Chakra will certainly be at the forefront spooking the enemy camp during war. Number 2. INS Vikramaditya. The 44,000-ton aircraft carrier will be the linchpin of the Indian Navy's war strategy. A carrier battle group is one of the most heavily armed and feared forces at sea. With a complement of 36 aircraft including 26 MiG-29K multi-role fighters and 10 Kamov early warning as well as anti-submarine helicopters, the carrier can establish a cordon sanitaire in the Arabian Sea. INS Vikramaditya has a range of 25,000 km at 18 knots and endurance of 45 days. The floating city has 110 officers and 1500 sailors on board. Number 1. Sukhoi Su-30 Warplanes. The Sukhoi 30 MKI, codenamed Flanker by NATO, is the Indian Air Force air dominance fighter. The Flanker is a heavy fighter bomber which has 12 hard points for a vast complement of missiles, rockets and smart bombs. It can carry a maximum payload of 8000 kg, although in a real-life battle scenario, payload is compromised to enhance range and to gain the edge in dogfights. The aircraft's super maneuverability gives it a huge advantage against its Western opponents. India has between 250 to 272 flankers, with the number likely to cross the 300 mark in order to make up for retiring MiG-21 and MiG-27 aircraft.